Imagine a vacuum. Not just any vacuum, like the one we might have thought of as kids. A cold, silent, lifeless void. Instead, picture the vacuum as a stage where the entire universe is constantly dancing, even if we can't see it. In this emptiness, something extraordinary is happening, something we only began to understand in the 20th century, thanks to the brilliant mind of Hendrik Casimir. In 1948, while working at Philips Labs, Casimir asked a question that might sound abstract at first. What happens when two perfectly conductive plates are placed extremely close together in a vacuum? The answer was surprising. These plates begin to attract each other. Not because of gravity, electromagnetism, or any other known force, but because of the vacuum itself. Yes, the same vacuum we mistakenly thought of as nothingness. In the quantum world, a vacuum isn't empty. It's more like a pulsating ocean of potential, where virtual particles appear and vanish in fractions of a second, creating what we might call an endless symphony of possibilities. When we place two plates in this space, we limit the electromagnetic waves that can exist between them. Outside the plates, all waves are possible, but between them, only specific ones. It's as if we've blocked a part of this quantum symphony. The result? A difference in energy that literally pushes the plates together. Here's where the magic begins. This force, called the Casimir effect, isn't something we feel in our everyday lives. It acts over distances as small as nanometers, but its existence was experimentally proven in the 1990s. And today, it plays a crucial role in nanotechnology, optics, and quantum engineering. Imagine microscopic devices where we can control the movement of components, not with electricity or mechanics, but with forces that emerge from nothing. Recent research takes this even further. Imagine being able to control the Casimir effect with incredible precision, using materials like topological insulators. In these materials, such as Weyl semimetals, Casimir forces can be switched from attractive to repulsive, opening up new possibilities for designing ultra-stable nanoscale devices. This isn't science fiction. It's a reality we're already starting to harness in nanotechnology. But there's more. The dynamic Casimir effect, where boundaries begin to move, can literally create photons out of nothing. Yes, you heard that right. Moving boundaries in a vacuum extract light from it, turning potential into reality. It's like reaching into quantum chaos and pulling something tangible out of it. Even more exciting, studies on multi-object Casimir systems reveal that quantum fluctuations can be controlled to transfer energy between three objects simultaneously, laying the foundation for revolutionary technologies like quantum transistors and future sensors. Now, think about this metaphorically. If a vacuum, something we associate with absolute nothingness, is full of possibilities, what does that say about us? About those moments in our lives that feel empty, aimless, or lifeless? Maybe those vacuums in our daily experience are like quantum fluctuations, ready to explode with creativity if we just find a way to tap into them. The Casimir effect is proof that science and philosophy aren't as far apart as they might seem. One seeks to understand how the world works, the other, why it exists at all. In both cases, what we discover reminds us of something deeper. Reality is more complex, beautiful, and paradoxical than we can imagine. So maybe, instead of fearing emptiness, we should embrace it. Because as the Casimir effect shows us, it's in the emptiness that the greatest potential lies. And remember, each of us is like that vacuum, a pulsating potential, ready to create something extraordinary, even if right now it feels like we have very little. Keep looking for ways to channel your inner energy, because it's your ideas, your determination, and your potential that can change the world around you. If you enjoyed this episode, don't forget to give it a thumbs up, subscribe to the channel, and let me know what you think in the comments. See you in the next one. Bye.